Three teenagers charged in a vicious school bus beating were sentenced to indefinite probation Thursday in a Florida juvenile court. The probation sentence for the trio of 15-year-olds came with multiple conditions including community service, random drug tests and electronic monitoring, meaning ankle bracelets for as long as 60 days. In addition, the teens must also take anger management classes, comply with mandatory curfews and stay away from the visit. Joshua Redden, Julian McKnight and Lloyd Kimraj had all pled guilty earlier Thursday to aggravated battery charges in the attack on a 13-year-old boy on a Pinellas County school bus in July. Redden also pleaded guilty to a count of robbery for taking $5 from the victim after the assault. Florida Circuit Judge Raymond Gross, in delivering the sentence, ordered Redden to pay restitution of the $5 and also ordered him to more community service than the other two. Prosecutors also asked for and were granted a measure stipulating that if any of the three students ended up at same high school as the victim, they had the burden to leave that school and go to another one. Police had said the teens attacked the victim after he told officials at their dropout prevention school that one of them tried to sell him marijuana. The victim suffered a broken arm and two black eyes after being repeatedly struck by punches and kicks. The attack was caught on video by a bus surveillance camera. If these matters were in adult court, they would be considered very serious, Gross said Thursday in Clearwater, Florida. The three teenagers are first-time offenders. Redden said he attacked the victim because he was angry and had been disrespected, but told Gross Thursday that he was sorry for the attack. Redden's mom, who was also in the courtroom, believed the video of the beating was shocking and appeared emotional as she said it was the first time she saw it. Redden's lawyer says his client was accused of something that he didn't do. Prior to McKnight's court appearance, his father also said his son was sorry for taking part in the attack. "All I can say is that he had his consequences already, you know," McKnight said. "This is life. I am sorry what happened to the victim. It's just the way it is. My son ain't never been no bad person, he just got mixed up with bad people, that's all. He's sorry."